Aaron, I'm sorry.
Right,
we're saying
it.
Shit.
I thought I created a recording sound.
Showtime. Mr. Thrice, rumor Thrice, Crystal Tizer, take snap 01. Do a moment, sir.
No.
What's next for the magistrates? Is it true that the government is increasing the amount of time?
I said no.
Please, rumor, the people have a right to know.
I have a right to do my job.
Shit.
I fucking quit.
What? Rumor, what are you talking about?
I can't stand this, Chief. All the publicity, the reporters, the cameras in my face. I can't do my job.
Rumor, just calm down.
Eat it, Crazel Pig, I'm done. I was this close to catching that goddamn cone last night, and guess who ruined it? Too bad that cone didn't kill one of those reporter fucks.
Rumor,
what's this organization become? Do you know who's out there right now?
Now that's enough, Rumor. We need you now more than ever. The amount of calls lately is skyrocketing, and we're running out of decent agents. Just look at these guys.
Yeah, take it.
Zachariah, where the fuck's that coffee?
Coming, sir.
Yeah, right, you little gangster.
I mean, Brylers, Jacobish, they're nobodies. If it wasn't for that Zachariah kid from the San Francisco division, we'd be screwed.
Yeah, and all the press followed him, too.
God damn it, Rumor, are you listening to me? You are the best agent we have. If you leave now, the LA division will go to shit. To shit.
It already has, Chief. I mean, maybe Brylers and Jacobish would be better agents if they didn't have fucking microphones shoved up their dicks all the time.
Rumor, you can't...
It's that goddamn documentary. Ever since that shit aired, everyone wants to be a fucking magistrate. I mean, why do you think the calls have been increasing? It's because the public always gets in the way. We never end up catching the monsters. We're always hunting the same fucking ones.
Well, what are we supposed to do about it?
I don't care. I quit.
What are you gonna do? Go freelance? You're never gonna make any money out there.
It's not about the money, Crazy Pig. It never has been. I can't stand the fact that there are monsters running around that aren't getting torn up to shit. I know if I go freelance, there are plenty of hicks and circus folk that are in need of our services.
Chief Crazy Pig, your coffee, sir.
Rumor?
I'm gonna go clean out my locker.
Rumor.
You people. Every time I'm on a mission, a fucking reporter always gets in the way. By putting that camera in my face, you're disallowing me to do my job, and you're letting more monsters run rampant in LA.
But what are you gonna do now that you've quit? Freelance? You won't make any money.
It's not about the money.
Excuse me?
It's not about the fucking money!
That was Rumor Thrice, formerly the Monster Magistrate, Los Angeles Division. Apparently, Rumor has decided to go freelance. So if any of you desperate country folks want your very own monster hunter, you should give Rumor a call. This is Crystal Geyser, KSNAP 01. Back to you, Tom.
And then I was like, well, a wall makes a better wall than a window.
Biggles.
Yes, sir?
I want you to find this man, Rumor Thrice. I want to talk to him.
Yes, sir.
And Biggles, don't introduce yourself until he does something worthwhile.
Yes, sir.
Mr. Drack?
My name, boy.
We have a minor problem, then. Or should I say, you have a minor problem.
What are you talking about? You know my parole officer?
No.
Hey! Hey! I know my rights! You magistrates don't operate outside metropolitan areas! Blah!
Who said anything about magistrates?
Please! I'm on parole from Blood Deal up north! And my sessions with Dr. Ciccotti are going well, too!
About time you found a new patient, Doc.
And so I die.
Marin, eh? Yeah, I've been there. Weird mix of hippies and yuppies, if you ask me. Not much to do, neither.
Where is it?
Bay Area. You know, north of San Francisco. But hey, man, if you're interested in a boring but expensive vacation, by all means, get your ass up there.
Marin. It doesn't sound like a bad idea. But before I leave LA, there's just one more thing I need to do.
Is this the real life? Is this just...
Patrick, honey, who is it?
Business or pleasure?
Is this the Dante residence?
Business or pleasure?
Business.
There we go. I'm with you, Dante. You want an autograph or something?
Actually, Mr. Dante, I'm an independent filmmaker. I was hoping to talk to you about hosting a special interest DVD that I'm producing. I mean, I've seen you work on Monster Magistrates, and you did a fantastic job on that.
Oh, thank you, Mr.
Hardcore Rob Lowe.
Hey, you wanna come in?
I'm not interrupting anything, am I?
Oh, don't be silly. This is Hardcore Rob Lowe.
Hi there. Such a strong name. Hardcore Rob Lowe. Oh my god, Patrick, he's beautiful.
Ruth, please excuse him. Have a seat.
Thanks, Patrick.
Oh, Lindale, please. Patrick's just a pen name that Krychek gave me. That's his real name, by the way. Can we get you anything to drink? Maybe coffee or tea or...
A stiff biscotti?
Krychek!
Tea's fine. Thanks.
Krychek, come help me in the kitchen. So, what's the DVD about, Rob?
It actually has a little bit to do with the magistrates.
Really?
Yeah. It has to do with media exposure and how it affects different areas of today's society. I was hoping to use the magistrates as an example.
Sounds deep.
Well, that's the idea. I was hoping you could be the host of the interviews, you know, since you've had first-hand experience on the subject.
Oh, I'd be delighted.
Great. Thanks.
Not many people know this, but that documentary was originally supposed to be a training film.
Really? I never would have thought.
Well, we got a little creative, and that's how I ended up with my little masterpiece.
What a masterpiece it is.
It's actually how Krychek and I first met. He was one of the magistrates in the video, if you remember.
Oh yeah, I thought you looked familiar.
Krychek quit to move down here with me, but what happened to the rest of San Francisco Division is a sad story.
Oh, how so?
Well, Zechariah was transferred, and we heard that Aloysius quit not too long ago.
And it just met its ultimate demise last week when Janosch disappeared.
Yeah, Egoprunt's got all rookies now. Couldn't come at a worse time with that mega monster on the loose in the Bay Area.
Mega monster?
Yeah, something like that, but we don't worry about that shit anymore. I've got bigger and better things in my life now.
Oh, you big beast, man.
I love you!
Oh,
you know, don't ever change, girl.
Girl.
You big beast.
I fucking hate that film.
Oh my god, Patrick, what's happened?
Shut it. Where you headed?
North.
Well then, up in, man. We be headed that way, too.
And then I was like, what do you want me to do? Punch a 17-year-old girl in the face? I mean, I'll do it, but I won't feel good about it. Oh, man. All right, I gotta go. I'll see you soon.
Hey man, the name's Scoots Magoo, and this here's Kega.
Hey,
what's up guys? The name's Rumor.
Pleasure making your acquaintance, man. The name's Scoots Magoo.
So where you guys headed?
Back home to Frisco.
Yeah man, we only be in LA for one thing. Locker number 420, man.
Yeah.
All the herb a young yardie could ask for. And a nice set of guns, man.
Nice.
I just got back from China a few days ago.
Oh yeah? You from there?
Yeah. I was actually trained to be an elite soldier for the Chinese government, but I recently retired.
How come? You're still pretty young.
Well, it's complicated.
How so?
Well, I ended up having to kill one of my former teammates to avenge my master's death. Master Lee. Later, I returned to China to visit my master's grave and share the news that I had killed Jin and thus avenged his death. But when I got back to China, a government official was waiting for me right after I got off the plane. He escorted me to a building near the airport where I was informed that I was to embark on my final but most important mission yet. I was to go back in time to act as my master's predecessor and train him as well as he had trained me so that later he could train me to one day avenge his death in the present. The time portal opened, and the next thing I know, I'm in 1960s China. I was pleased to see my master again, even though he did not yet know who I was. I was also surprised that, even in his youth, he wore a similar face mask to the one he had when I trained under him. We began to train immediately, and Master Lee quickly became a fluid fighter. Taught Master Lee as much as he had taught me until I was sure he was ready. Once it was time for me to leave, I passed my robe down to him and contacted the officials in the present to be brought back home to the 21st century. And now, unless a better opportunity presents itself, I'm headed to Hollywood to try to sell my story to a movie producer.
Wow. Sounds like you got everything figured out.
I'm sorry to bother you, sir, but I have to admit, I was just eavesdropping on your story there.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. What if I told you that I might have a better opportunity for you?
What kind of opportunity?
Monster hunting.
Mon.
I can tell when you walked in the door that you're more than just an ordinary person. What's your name?
River Thrice.
River Thrice? Jerome.
What do you say, Jiro?
Thanks for the ride, Scoots.
No problem.
Thanks, man. Hope to see you guys around soon.
Sounds like a plan, G.
So where are we heading now?
North.
What's a cone doing in the middle of the forest anyway?
Shh. Bomber said it was around here.
Jidge was like, if you don't stop calling me a Tyrannosaurus Rex, I'm gonna come over there and strangle you. And then I said, yeah, if you could fucking reach me. I'll call you back later.
Sorry. My name is Viggles, and I represent Mr. Zedekiah Jones. Would you mind lowering your weapons? I am unarmed. I don't know if you're familiar with the occurrences of a unique creature up north, but my employer is interested in hiring someone to find and kill it for a hefty reward.
What kind of reward?
Monetary, the amount of which can be discussed at a later date if you would be interested in visiting Mr. Jones at his offices in San Francisco.
How'd you find us?
Zedekiah sent me to follow you after he heard the news that you quit the Monster Magistrates.
Magistrates?
I'm sure Zedekiah wouldn't mind if you brought your two new companions to the meeting.
He's not my companion.
Should I inform Zedekiah of your intentions to meet with him?
Yeah, I'll be there.
Good. He'll be expecting you within the week. Good day, gentlemen.
Yo, what's your deal, man?
I think it's about time you left, too.
What? Yo, I saved your life. Why are you being such a prick?
Mad Street, fuck.
Not anymore.
So you quit because of the documentary, too?
Yep. I felt the same way Rumor did. Felicity got too much, so I quit. I was always sort of a loner anyway. It wasn't too hard.
How long have you been going solo?
About 3 months. Since I left, I've been working with some supernatural stuff. Black magic.
What are you? A magician?
Check it out. I've been working on a new one lately. I call it the mirror spell.
What does it do?
Just watch Rumor.
Did you do it?
Kira, what are you doing?
It's not me.
Mirror spell, man. Been working on it for a while.
Cute. Let him go.
Done.
So, do you think you might want to come to see that Zedekiah guy with us?
Sure. It's always nice to have some company every once in a while.
Good, because I'm not sure what we're going to be up against. Be glad to have you around.
Oh yeah? What happened to Magistrate? Fuck.
Look, man, I'm sorry. I didn't know, alright?
Cool. Cool, man.
Well, good night, guys. I'll see you in the morning.
Aloysius, you mind?
What do you know if it ain't my old friend, Rumor?
Hey, man.
Looks like you got some new friends, too. Y'all need a ride?
You mind?
Not at all. I'm tired of listening to all these tromo theories demos. Hop in.
Music power.
Yo, my method for my musical madness, move and motivate those with musical talents. Read it in bold print, we holding it down. Lick a shot, hip hop when we in your town. Master blast the sound, reach the future far from here and now. We'll stop, release, increase the peace. Bubble with the beat, they feeling the heat in the streets. Now each one, teach one, reach one, young gun on one. Listen to the warrior's drum, beating up the block with the ghetto hop that knock and make you wanna crash your spot and the lock explode. Boom. The alpha and omega code with drum rolls and old soul. We uphold and foretold your scores of 6 years ago. Fast flow and G-Rap the cool mode. Super syllable, major to the minimal. Every individual bound to the temple, yo. Lungs collapsing, raps be trapped in. The only way to make it happen, jaw jabbing fast, yo. Rapping.
It's open.
And then Nelpool said, but aren't you just bored and a little bit curious? Rumor Thrice.
Mr. Jones? Zedekiah Jones?
Please, just Zedekiah. A pleasure to meet you.
Yeah, you too.
So I know you've met my right-hand man, Viggles. And to my right is Dr. Owen FTR. Viggles informed me that you would be interested in doing some work for us. In return for your services, I'm prepared to offer you a total of $300,000. How does that sound?
Sounds like a deal.
Good. Now, Viggles also told me that you might be bringing some extra company with you. Aloysius, if I'm not mistaken.
Yeah. Documentary, right?
Yes. And who might your friend from the Orient be?
Jiro Ming. I've just come back from an important mission from China to train my former masters so that he may train me.
Jiro. So what's this job, Zedekiah? Something about a monster you need taken care of?
Not just any monster, Rumor. What's unique about this one is the source of its powers.
Powers?
Yes. Dr. TR, would you mind explaining?
Certainly. The monster we're having you hunt is not necessarily a monster by definition. It holds a very powerful, very valuable orb in its hand. Anyone that comes into contact with this orb is immediately and hideously transformed.
Into what?
That's the interesting part. I've been studying the lore of the orb for quite some time, and found that it's an ancient artifact that the 16th century pirate Blacky McBlackBlack the blackest pirate of them all, brought to the Americas from Eastern Europe. The orb combines the characteristics of the three most common monsters of the world, all of which originate around the same time in Eastern Europe. Contact with the orb transfers both the abilities and the curses of each monster to anyone unfortunate enough to touch it with his bare skin.
So this is just a person we're after?
Don't dismiss it just like that, Rumor.
Zedekiah is right. To underestimate this creature would be very foolish. As I mentioned, the orb's host takes on the attributes of three different monsters. The fangs and bloodlust of a vampire, the hairy appearance and aggressive nature of a werewolf, and the desensitized state of a mindless zombie.
So when it has all the attributes of all these other monsters, is it susceptible to sunlight like a vampire?
Yes, but it has been known to strike during the day, albeit in darker areas. You must be aware that—
Wait. Why don't you guys just have the magistrates take care of this?
Originally they tried. But one of their agents has already disappeared searching for it, and is presumed dead.
Who? Which one?
Who was it? The werewolf one.
Janosch.
I'm sorry you're upset, but I was under the impression you left the organization not too long ago.
I did, but... old friendships.
It's all for the best, anyway. I'd rather not get the government involved, considering this is a special case with special circumstances. As you can see, I am a collector.
Right. So you're willing to offer a considerable amount of money.
True. 300,000, was it?
Yeah, up front.
I'm sorry, I can't do that. I am a businessman.
Up front.
Viggles? I only work with professionals, Rumor. You are a professional, right?
Yes.
Then please, control yourself. If you're going to accept my proposal, you're going to have to deal with getting your reward after you've delivered the orb.
Fine. So, where do we find this thing?
Start with the headlands. The last reported killing occurred there.
You guys, can we stop for a second? Nature's calling.
I guess we'll just take a break then.
Excuse me, gentlemen. But what are you doing here?
Who the hell are you?
We are the Knights of Justice. I assume you haven't heard of us.
No, I heard of you. Bunch of holy rolling assholes, if you ask me.
We get that a lot.
What are you doing here?
We asked first.
Hunting a dangerous monster.
Jiro. Look, you guys should get out of here. This monster's pretty unpredictable.
We know. We also know your ignorance is not welcome here.
If anyone is going to deal with this creature, it is we three.
Who'd you guys say you were? The Dykes of Justice?
Ugh! We are not homosexual women.
We believe in the teachings of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior, as should you.
See what you mean by holy rollers.
It is in His name that we follow our worthy cause. Since the Crusades, our establishment has sought out and destroyed every manner of supernatural beast known to man.
Recently, there's been an overabundance of supernatural activity in this part of the world. It is our duty to rid this place of it. So, gentlemen, please step aside and let us continue our hunt.
I don't think so.
We knew you'd be a problem, Magistrate.
Your kind always gets in the way. Leave this place and let us continue our mission.
There's no magistrates here. Not anymore. We're getting paid by an outside source to do this thing.
We're doing you guys a favor. Why does it matter if we kill it first?
The Catholic Church does not accept favors from heathens.
Hey, whatever you say, boss. Jiro, Aloysius, let's go.
If you leave now, do not return. Be warned, the Knights of Justice are not a force to be meddled with.
Gentlemen?
The Knights of Justice.
I first heard of them when I joined the Magistrates a few years ago. As far as I know, the organization's had problems with them since day one.
What, they have jurisdiction over the entire world or something?
Exactly.
Yeah, you could tell.
I think they associated my shirt with the Magistrates. That's probably why we received such a hostile greeting.
We better keep on trying to find this thing. Any more competition, we're not getting paid.
Agreed.
Careful, Balthazar. You're gonna poke somebody's eye with that thing.
Oh, yeah? If you want something done yourself, do it?
Balthazar! Gaspar!
Sorry, sir. Just growing anxious.
And I as well. I think we may have made a mistake by letting those three go this afternoon.
What do you suggest we do?
I got a spade knife. Let's kill him.
That would not be very Christian of us.
Drastic situations call for drastic tactics.
He's right, Melchior. We mustn't let them encumber our mission.
Very well. We strike tomorrow morning.
I know this place.
Sure.
This is where I killed Jin.
I'll handle this.
because I do not originate from the Orient.
Huh, I would never dream of it.
My martial arts skills far surpass anything you could fathom.
Huh, I would never dream of it.
Let us continue our bout.
Huh, I would never dream of it.
I mean, Clamato. You don't just make drinks out of animals.
Seneca, I finished it.
You've got it? The glove?
You finished it?
Yes. With this glove, you'll be able to control the orb's power.
Your shows will work, Owen?
Yes. All it needs are two catalysts to help you focus on controlling the orb's power. That's where Viggles and I come in.
Beautiful.
Owen. Owen.
Rumor, did you bring me the orb? Let me see it.
Let's see the money.
Right. Viggles?
Looks like we got a deal.
Welcome to K-Snap 01's third very exciting edition of Contemporary Heroes of California. We're here live in adventurer-turned-Hollywood star Jiro Ming's very own Beverly Hills estate. And joining us today are three very special young men that less than a year ago saved the San Francisco Bay Area from Zedekiah Jones, a young, power-obsessed collector of exotic artifacts. So, without further ado, let's meet our three guests. Aloysius, Jiro Ming, and Rumor Thrice. Gentlemen, it's great to have you on the show.
It's great to be here, Miss Jizzer.
Oh, that's Kaiser, thanks. So let's get right into it. After you guys foiled Zedekiah's plans and destroyed his mythical orb, you split up, right?
That's right.
Now, Aloysius, you're currently in the process of putting together a new covert monster hunting organization in the same vein of Monster Magistrates, correct?
Yeah.
Can you tell us a little bit about that?
No, not really.
Oh, okay.
Covert.
I was told that we'd be meeting your first recruit on the show today, but it seems that he's not ready yet.
Yeah, he falls asleep unexpectedly on occasion, but you just gotta smack him in the chest with the billy club. He's awake in no time.
Okay, great. So I guess we'll be meeting him later then. Jiro?
Hey, baby.
Jiro, your Hollywood career has just recently been jump-started, and you're now starring in the upcoming film Avarice, based on your true story. You've already been compared to established international action superstars and are being called the next Sammo Hung. How have these experiences and comments changed your way of life?
Well, I don't think I've changed a bit, Crystal. I mean, I just bought this new Beverly Hills estate and signed a 3-picture deal with Sony. Nah, I think I'm still the same on Jiro.
Well, that's good news. I'm glad to hear it. So, rumor. I know that we've shared some harsh moments in the past, and before we continue, I would like to apologize for any inconvenience to you that I or anyone from my staff has caused.
Well, thank you, Crystal. You know, you're the first journalist to ever apologize to me for that. But regardless, I'm over it. In fact, I'm over Monster Hunting altogether. Have been for a while.
Oh, well, that's news to me. Why the change?
Well, I realize that the creatures that I've been hunting have every right to live in this world as you or I. I don't know exactly how I came to that decision, but I think it has something to do with the fact that violence has so dominated my life since I was, like, 18 or something. Anyways, I just felt like I needed, you know, a change of pace to mellow out, you know, let it be, if you will. Yep, it's the end of the road for old Rumor Thrice. With the money I saved, I invested in a ranch house up in Napa, with some livestock, a sex swing in the basement, some Hindu guy that just hangs around. You know, the American dream.
Wow, that was very profound, Rumor. Thank you. I'm getting word that our fourth guest is ready to join us. So without further ado, let's bring out former Monster Magistrate, Krychak.
This is for Patrick, you piece of shit!
Thank you.